내가 제일 잘나가 내가 제일 잘나가
The US authorities are investigating the leak of details claiming to show how little tax is paid by some of America's richest people. According to the ProPublica news outlet, the 25 wealthiest Americans pay tax at a far lower rate than the average worker. The website alleges that Amazon's Jeff Bezos paid no tax in 2007 and 2011, while Elon Musk, the founder of Tesla, paid nothing in 2018, claims the BBC hasn't been able to verify independently. Our North America correspondent Peter Bowes has more.
The US government, the Treasury Department, says that any leaking of confidential information like this would be illegal and that the FBI has been informed and is investigating this leak. So we don't know exactly where they got the information from. They're describing it as a vast trove of detail from the IRS, the Internal Revenue Service, relating to some of America's richest people dating back over 15 years. So they claim to have seen these tax returns, and as you outlined, certain individuals, and they're very specific on the years that they say these people paid absolutely nothing in terms of taxes. Now, they're not accusing these multi-billionaires of doing anything illegal. What they are suggesting, and this really won't come as a surprise to many people, is that they are, to use a phrase, playing the system, playing the American system, and it is all above the law. This is a system here of taxation based on income, but it doesn't take into account the vast wealth of certain individuals through stocks and property, the wealth that is increasing year on year. And it says that they've employed techniques that are not accessible to ordinary people. And that's because they have these great areas of wealth in stocks and property. Most people in this country, of course, just live paycheck to paycheck, and they're taxed on their salaries.
Peter Bowes. Well, I've been speaking to Alex Cobham, who's chief executive of the Tax Justice Network here in the UK, and I asked him if any of this surprised him.
No, sadly. You know, it's interesting in a sense to see the details for individuals, but we know there are issues in the US and other tax systems. We don't tax high wealth well. We don't tax the highest incomes at all well. And in the case of the US, the IRS has been so stripped of resources that actually you're much less likely to get audited at the top income levels than much further down. And of course, that leads to people simply paying less tax, almost as a choice they make themselves.
Now, ProPublica themselves, who released this information, say that this was all using perfectly legal tax strategies. But I'm just curious to know, I mean, how is it that ordinary people are paying far more of their tax in percentage term than these billionaires?
Well, this unfortunately is something that's locked into most of our tax systems. We've increasingly moved to taxing consumption, which hits the people with lowest income, people who spend most of their incomes, the people with lowest incomes. But also, we haven't put the resources into making sure that people at the top aren't gaming the system. And we know that the likes of the big four accounting firms and others spend a lot of time and make a lot of money by advising people on how not to pay taxes. One issue there is, you know, if we had consistent transparency instead of relying on leaks, we actually had this kind of data published regularly, you'd get a kind of political accountability to make sure the people at the top are paying more. Well, and that's really been eroded.
Right. So the more money you have, the better people you can get, as it were, to help you pay less tax in legal methods. I wondered, the billionaires, I suppose, would say that they create thousands of jobs, they give millions, if not billions, to charitable and philanthropic causes. They do their bit, and if they paid more income tax, they wouldn't be able to do all that.
I mean, that's just not true. You know, we know that a lot of the billionaires' giving actually ends up in foundations under their own name that give them tax advantages, but where they keep control of their money and shouldn't have those tax advantages. But in addition, they continue to go around the world, in a sense, dictating policies. If we think about Bill Gates in international development, for example, in a way that simply shouldn't be possible if we're thinking about taxing for the common good. That billionaire wealth shouldn't be about giving them power, allowing them to wash their reputations. It should be contributing, as the rest of us do, a reasonable share of tax back into the system that we all pay for, that we all benefit from. Paying tax is a social act, and billionaires should be contributing to society just as much as the rest of us.
Now, the immediate response from the White House wasn't to express any kind of dismay at how little tax is reportedly being paid by billionaires, but to go after the leak of information. But, I mean, what do you make of Joe Biden's plans to try to make the wealthiest pay more? Will they work?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's definitely a desire from the Biden administration to catch up with some of the more progressive countries like Argentina that have already responded to the pandemic by introducing wealth taxes, by looking at excess profits taxes on the companies that have done particularly well in the pandemic. And the Biden administration really has set a path that I think others can follow too, ending the race to the bottom on corporate taxation and making sure that you're getting some level of wealth and high income taxation on those at the top of the distribution.